Avengers Assemble! Today on Just Takes 5, how should you watch the Marvel Cinematic Universe? Hey, what's up everybody? Courtney Morris here, Just Takes 5. And today we're gonna take 5 minutes to talk about what is the best way to watch the Marvel movies in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. A lot of you guys have asked me to talk about this because you're not quite sure. And what you need to know is that there's a couple of different ways that you can watch them. You can either watch them in the chronological order, which would be the actual years that the movies take place in, or you can watch them in the order that Marvel went ahead and put them out. Now, you can watch them in whatever order you want. There's also a third way to watch it, which is called the spaghetti order, but I'll let you look that one up on your own. Today, we're not going to do the chronological. We're not going to do the spaghetti. We're going to do the normal way that the Marvel Cinematic Universe was brought out. And the reason why I think this is the best way to watch it is because Marvel went ahead and made sure that they placed things into these movies, whether it be Easter eggs, whether it be post-credit scenes, whatever it might be, where they were leading up and telling this story as a whole. And so that's what we're gonna look at today. So let's start with phase one. Iron Man starts off the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Back in 2008, Marvel released their first film, Tony Stark and How He Becomes Iron Man. The other great thing about this is that in that movie, they also set up the Black Widow, which you don't really quite know that she's the Black Widow unless you're kind of a comic book fan. And they also set up Agent Coulson, who then comes in later in some other movies, as well as having his own TV show called Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. After that, we go into the second movie, which is The Incredible Hulk. Bruce Banner and the Hulk are played by Edward Norton, who's later recasted by Mark Ruffalo. But this movie was kind of a flop, which was kind of a bummer because The Incredible Hulk is my absolute favorite character in the whole entire Marvel Cinematic Universe. I love him. From here, they go on to their third film, which is Iron Man 2. So here now in the first three films of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, you have two films that are Iron Man. Now, for some people watching this for the first time, you might think that that's a little too much Tony Stark in three movies. But honestly, can you really ever have too much Tony Stark? After Iron Man 2, we head into the movie of Thor, where Thor is introduced as this amazing kind of powerful character. It shows us a little bit that there are characters outside of Earth and those types of things. But also in here, we get Hawkeye. We see him during part of the movie. So here, Marvel is setting up these different characters for bigger and greater things. And again, that's why I think that watching them this way, it's really, really nice. Although it jumps back and forth through the timeline a little bit, it's really, really awesome to see how they build up these different characters. From Thor, then, we go into Captain America, the First Avenger. And this is where it's a little crazy, right? Because if he's the First Avenger, why would they go ahead and put Captain America here? And the reason being is because this movie takes place way before, right? Way before any of the other movies took place. And that's why it's really, really important to do this movie now, because it sets up a couple of different things. One, it sets up the Tesseract and talks about that. So sorry if you haven't ever seen any of these movies, but you'll learn about the Tesseract. But it sets up the Tesseract. It sets up Captain America in order for him to come back. It sets up all of these different types of storylines that are then going to be used in the next film, which is the last film in phase one from the Marvel Cinematic Universe, which is Avengers Assemble. It is where all of your favorite characters are coming together to fight against Loki, Thor's brother, in order to save the Earth. And from here, we see all of these different characters from different films coming together. There's mentions of different ones. Coulson's in there. Nick Fury's in there, who's been sprinkled throughout the films. Maria Hill's in there. Just multiple different people coming to end phase one with this amazing movie called Avengers Assemble.